So the Jagdpanzer that we are going to have a look at today, we have seen a few times on this channel before. I'm not really going in depth on the history of the Jagdpanzer, but in short, most of these vehicles we see on display today are almost all G14 post-war Swiss Jagdpanzers. And a lot of these museums will claim that their Jagdpanzer is a genuine World War II vehicle and say it was made into a G14 after the war. In real life, there are only 12 original ones left in the world. You might have noticed that I'm not calling it a Hetzer, and that's because it was never called Hetzer during the war. It got the name Hetzer for a short while after the mistake the Skoda factory made. They mixed up the E10 prototype with this vehicle. The first tanks had this name, but was shortly removed from the documentation. The name Hetzer was later made popular in books, and it stuck, of course, because the name Hetzer sounds a lot better and it's easy to remember. This Jagdpanzer is, of course, a G14 that was given to the military museum in Brussels, Belgium. When the museum in Brussels had no more room to spare, they shipped it over to the Bastogne barracks, where it was restored to running condition. The nice people over at the Bastogne barracks claimed that this was probably a World War II Hetzer and that it was made into a G14 after the war, but I could not find any real evidence to support this. The restoration of this vehicle took almost 2 years and was restored by using all the original parts still on the vehicle. The museum tries to use all the original parts even when they are pretty rusted. Some parts were of course recreated and some were replaced, like the engine. Of course, for a more reliable modern French engine. A lot of museums and private collectors make this decision because a post-war engine is much more reliable and cheaper than the original one. So did I spot any G14 stuff on this Jagdpanzer, and do I think it's a real Hetzer? Probably not, and that's because real Hetzers are extremely rare. And even if the body was made in World War II, it's still 90% post-war. But how do you spot a G14 from a real World War II vehicle? Now, with all the post-war additions on it, it's still pretty easy. You can look at the gun. If it has a muzzle brake on it or a spare wheel to the side, it's most of the time a G14. But if people have restored it to look like a World War II vehicle, it will get a little bit harder. What you can look for is an escape hatch, because the later G14s had these, and this is always a 90% proof it's a G14. And now you probably think, but what about the serial numbers? Most serial numbers were changed by the Swiss, so that's most of the time a dead end. And other things to look out for to spot a G14 are the idler wheels and of course the gun, because the G14 would have the Stuk 40 gun. But nonetheless, this Jagdpanzer is beautifully restored by the restoration team at Bastogne Barracks. They also had help of local schools that have made parts for this vehicle, and they did an amazing job. This is also a great way to let students join in on this project and learn about World War II and the historical importance of restoring these vehicles. But you're of course all here to see the end result, and I will be switching over to Live Me in a minute, and we will have a look at the end result. Enjoy! So welcome back, this is Live Me. So I had a small opportunity that day to start filming because it was snowing all day and it was really cold. So yeah, I was really glad it stopped snowing for a minute. So I could rush out and film this. Yeah, if you wonder what this tactical marking means, it just means Jagdpanzer. So it could mean Jagdpanzer 38 for this one, or it could mean Jagdpanzer 4. Yeah, you can see that I was struggling trying to find the right options for my camera because my hands were freezing and I didn't have any camera gloves or something. A nice Balkenkross, some really nice camo. Some antenna mountings. I have no idea if that is typical for the Hatcher. Maybe it's a G13 option. I have no idea. And you can see it starts snowing again. And yeah, you can also see that the idler wheels has 4 holes, and I think that's also typical for a G13. Also the new deck engine over there, and new deck plates and new exhaust pipe, because this is a running version of the Jagdpanzer. Of course, I mean it's restored to running condition. Not a running version, I have no idea why I said that. As you can see, the amazing attention to detail they restore things in. Great camouflage. Of course, the tactical marking over there. It has an antenna mounting. That's typical G13. I think that that mounting over there is also typical G13. 4-hold idler. And a 201. I have no idea if that 201 has anything to do with the Battle of Bulge. I can't find any information on a tactical number 201 with an Hatcher that was fighting in the Battle of the Bulge, so I have no idea what that tactical number stands for, or why they chose 201 as the tactical number. Great camouflage over there, of course, the tracks, panning shot, and a panning shot of the gun. And that last part, most people think that the if this muscle brake is unscrewed, it's a G13, but most of the Hatchers had a normal muscle brake on it, but they had a flat one they could screw on there on the end of the gun. So it's not, if you see a screw top on it, or how do you call it, it's not typical for a G13. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and let me know what you think about the G13 and the Hatcher, and if you think this is considered a Hatcher now or still a G13.